If you're a fan of hockey like myself and don't really enjoy having to boot up your Xbox or your PS4 every single time you want to play the newest installment of NHL, you're really looking for a game on your computer to have instead. Well, guess what? You're actually shit out of luck, because there hasn't been an NHL game on PC since 09. That's NHL 09, which released in 2008. That's almost 11 goddamn years ago, and we are in dire need from someone or something to save us from... Oh my god... Well, that'll have to do it. Yes, you're seeing this right. It's not NHL, it's not NHL 2K, and it's not whatever goddamn off-street road NHL this is, but it's a hockey game on PC, that is for sure. Slapshot is a 3v3 physics-based hockey game that released on Steam on March 8th of 2019 to really, really great reviews. Like, I'm really surprised how... overwhelmingly positive these reviews have been. The dev team behind it is at Glacier Labs and consists of only two devs so far who created this as hockey enthusiasts and just as a love hobby project for themselves so they can have a hockey game on PC finally. The game is simple. Honestly, you hit the puck, you wiggle your stick, and you get a goal. And that's honestly it. That's how you play hockey. The challenge from the game comes from that there's no, actual setup of controls here like you would have in your normal NHL game. There's usually, a pass button, a shoot button, maybe even, a deke button, but there's nothing. There's no normal control setup in this game. There's no form of puck glue, as I like to call it, keeping the puck glued to your player before you actually make a pass or you get knocked on your ass by somebody else. Controls are very simple, though. You move your mouse left or right to spin your player to that direction. You can use shift to get a quick dash, which is the sprint mechanic in this game. There's a bar at the bottom, which only allows you to do a certain amount, but it does fill up very quick. And then the space bar to do a hard stop on the ice and prevent you from barreling into your teammates into the net. It's an easy to learn and hard to master setup here because it's physics-based. You only have a small range of motion, you have a small range of controls, and you're really at wit's end with... physics, the world, whatever physics engine, whatever world they built, that's what you have to deal with. But once you have a basic idea of what you're doing here, you'll start yeeting that puck into the goal and getting a juicy, juicy rebound score. Two of my friends and I have been grinding this game for the past week, and we've really started to get an overall, understanding of the function and motions of the game, which was really hard at first, and we were really garbage, as you might be able to see from some of the clips playing in the background here. But it's been a hell of a ride, and I've had a really fun time with this game. I've never had fun starting a game that I wasn't good at. If I'm not good at a game, I usually either try my best to get better, or I just drop the game and don't come back to it for a very long time. But this is a game I really wanted to stick to, because it's the only hockey game we have on the computer that is... being consistently updated today, and it's on Steam and it's free. I mean, for God's sake, it's free. It's free to play. You can play it on as many accounts as you want. If you want to play it on different places, you want to take it to your friend's house that they don't have Steam, just tell them to download Steam. It doesn't take much to run either. The graphics in this game are not demanding. It is not very well optimized just yet because the game just came out, so if you have a weaker computer, it might be a little harder to run. It's not a Fortnite of games. It might not be able to run on everything, but still, it's not the hardest game to run. Your FPS counter and everything, there's not a lot of video settings on there. You can't really change what it looks like. It's a basic looking game, but you can't really change it from high, medium to low, so you're pretty much stuck with what they give you. There's some options here and there, but it doesn't really make much of a difference. But anyway, this game is just so damn fun to play. Now, it does come with some issues. I know I've been talking really great about this game, but there are a giant list of bug fixes that they're working on. You're disconnecting from a match after a minute, and a lot of people have that issue and they haven't had a fix for it yet, but hopefully they get something going on soon. You can have high latency input lag. When I was home for my spring break from college, I had the worst input lag in the entire world, but when I got back, it was fine, so it's machine dependent. I don't really know how that works, and sometimes you'll be matched into an uneven game, which means you'll get... The game is played 3v3, as I said, but sometimes you'll get matched into a 4v3 game, and it's four people, one extra person on the ice is a lot, and it makes it for a really crowded game and a really uneven game. Actually, it might even come at a disadvantage to the other team, because having four people on your ice gets really crowded. You don't know where the puck is, and the puck can just leak into the net. And there's some other minor issues, like they had NA West servers go up, and they had some issues with that, so they had to take them down, but they have a whole list of things that they're trying to work on, and they've been really quick to monitor all these things, even with just two people. They've been doing quick patches like this last weekend. They fixed a long, glaring list of bugs that happened over the past 2 weeks, and they got them all patched up, and the game is starting to run a lot smoother, and it's really good that just two people can get this done so quick. As I said, the game is free to play on Steam now, and you have ability to customize your character to the full extent. You'll need to buy the quote-unquote Slappy Pass, which was just renamed from the full version of the game for $9.99, which will give you access to a whole bunch of cosmetics if you want to. If you're into that thing, I might buy it myself if I get good enough at the game that I can consider I'll start playing it for a long time. But right now, it's honestly If you want to be able to make your character have like a black eye and a goofy smile, you're going to want to buy the Slappy Pass. I'm not doing it for right now, and I don't know anyone else who has, but I'm definitely going to have to do it at some point if I get good enough at the game. And that's going to do it for the video today, guys. If you guys want to check out Slapshot, it is free to play on Steam right now. I am not sponsored or anything in the way of this game. I want to thank Glacier Labs for finally getting a decent hockey game put on PC, because it's been way too long. And EA, if you're watching this, for the love of God, give us an NHL game next year. Alright guys, that's going to do it for me. Thank you guys so much for watching, getting your daily dose of vitamin P. If you guys want more daily doses of vitamin P, please check out the rest of the videos on my channel. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace out, and take care.